according to Paul, if you're up here talking, you don't need a mask. Okay, please join me in the call of worship. Invited by God. Partnering with God. Now please stand for the opening hymn, which is My Hope Is Built. And all the words are going to be up here since we do not have hymn notes nor bulletins.
Thank you. For those of you who are here, for those that are watching later on at home, and Sunday is a time to recognize the work and mission of all laity, not only within the walls of the church, but in everyday lives. First, I want to commend the laity here. We have four of us, and I may be missing somebody, but if, when I call your name, just please stand where you're at. Charles Stenger, Leslie Calabrese, Wayne Peter is not here, and myself. We are your laity members for East Shore Church, and thank you for serving. If any of you are still interested in becoming a laity member, the North Coast District has classes in the spring and fall. Just go to their website and you can sign up. It's not too late. So my topic is, sermon topic is Lean on Me. And you probably heard the song by Bill Weathers, and I won't sing it, but I'll just read it. It goes, lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm going to need somebody to lean on. Let us pray. Turn these words I speak into living bread and Peter helpers. Amen. There's not a burden that I can't carry. There's nothing that I can't do. Jesus is always there. Amen?
Amen.
COVID-19 has resulted in a pandemic that has devastated the entire world. Many people are hurting, confused, and frustrated. Tragically, some people have even died, and we may know some of them in our own lives. And it's still not over. We are waiting for the vaccine. And if that isn't enough, protesting and other tragedies are occurring. Thankfully, the Lord God Almighty has a solution for all of this, as well as every other problem in our lives. Seeing things from God's perspective, which means that you see God in all things. Trust God with all things and experience God through all things. This involves making sure that you have received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Once you have become one in spirit with the God, you will always have spiritual eyes to see God and to hear God. The result, you will be able to see things from God's point of view. You will be able to deal with the problems of life so that you will be able to get the most out of your life. Only then you can truly enjoy the good times and endure the hard times. This begins by an act of faith on your part. By faith, you need to embrace the Bible reading, which I read earlier, Proverbs 3, verses 5 through 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not rely on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will direct your path. First is trust. Trust is very unique. It is a God-given quality common to all mankind. Yet it is often misguided. God never intended that we rely upon our own limited human understanding, but rather that we would trust completely in all-knowing God, whose understanding is unlimited and infallible. Yet ever since the fall of mankind in the Garden of Eden, everyone has ignorantly been struggling to live from the tree of knowledge. In this, we all have been leaning on our own understanding. However, this has resulted in a meager existence at best. Certainly, not the abundant life that our Creator God has intended for us to enjoy. But there is good news. God has granted us the capacity to trust in order that we would entrust our lives to Him and live. God wants us to live a full and meaningful life. Total surrender. So what about you? How is your life going? Who or what are you relying on to make it through life? It should be evident by now that you, along with the entire human race, are woefully relying on your own human understanding, and stop trying to figure out what Jesus would do so that you can imitate him. Imitation is a poor substitute for the real thing. Jesus Christ is the life, the one and only true life. This life, and he alone can live it. Jesus Christ came to indwell you in order that he might live this life through you. But you must live it. Therefore, entrust your life totally to our Lord Jesus Christ. Trust him completely with every detail of every area of your life. Then simply rest in him, and he will do everything else. Total lordship. How many of us actually acknowledge the Lord God Almighty in all our ways? Oh, we think we're quick to acknowledge the problem, the circumstances, the people, or even the devil. We rarely express words of dismay, frustration, anger, or hostility. And finally, if all else fails, some of us might even ask God for help. But an appeal for help does not constitute an acknowledgement. Acknowledgement. What does it mean to acknowledge God? Okay, Lord, what should I do now? I acknowledge Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. I am his servant. Guide me and keep me. It means you recognize that Jesus is the Lord in your life, in all of your circumstances, and the path he would have you to take. Here are some ways to acknowledge him in all your ways. First, you recognize his presence in all things. You accept his control of everything. You see him working in and through all things. You submit to his lordship over everything. You talk to him about everything. You follow him and his leadings in all things. For this to be possible, only after you have entrusted your total self to the Lord Jesus Christ, you are actively trusting him with all your heart. This is why Proverbs 3:5 tells you that you must first trust in the Lord with all your heart. Once you do, then you will be able to readily acknowledge his lordship in all your ways, and then he will direct your path. As you remain focused on the solution, Jesus Christ your Lord, he will guide you in the right direction. Therefore, make it a point to acknowledge the Lord first and foremost in everything, and at all times. Thank the Lord in all things and for all things. Then trust him to lead you through it. The gift of God, and it's all because God's mercy and grace. Therefore, it is time to simply agree with God by calling it like it is. And as you do this, you will begin to see God in all things, trusting God in all things, and experiencing God through all things. And that is a good thing, a very good thing. So in closing, here's a wonderful fact to apply of what I just read to you. Whatever is worrying you right now, forget about it. Take a deep breath, trusting God, because God loves you and can't do anything about it. Now all storms come to disrupt your life, some to clear your path. In Joshua 1, verse 9, reads, "Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go." The Lord will fight for you while you only need to keep silent and remain calm. Psalm 46, verse 10, "Be still and know that I am God." Hebrews 13, verse 8, "Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and he will be forever." And if you feel like losing everything, remember that
Please pray with me. Loving God, we come before you. We thank you for the change of seasons, for autumn colors, and the beauty of nature. We are thankful for this life and all the many blessings you have given us, for family, for smiles, for laughter, and celebrations. We are grateful for your love and compassion during these days of COVID and unrest. We pray for physical and mental healing for those who are ill or sad and lonely. Comfort those who have lost loved ones. We pray for our first responders, frontliners, military, educators, workers, parents, and families. We pray for those who are unemployed, hungry, homeless, and struggling. Lord, we lift up our church to be a strong, compassionate, loving congregation in our community. A beacon of hope, we lift up and appreciate Pastor Armand, Debbie, and their family. We lift up the names on our prayer list with your healing touch. We lift up our country and our leaders. Give them wisdom and guidance. Lord, we give you thanks and praise for your Son, Jesus. Be with us and guide us to be your example this week. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory.
a reminder, on your way out from the church this afternoon, please drop your offering in the basket when you exit the sanctuary. And now we'll have our doxology.
Personal situations are today, God will renew and refresh us with our faith and hope through Him. So may God be with you, may His countenance be with you, and give you peace. Amen. Blessed day, go in peace.